Very good afternoon to all of you. So we have reached the final day of our FDP on LaTeX, an art of writing research manuscript. So far, all these 3 days, we have learnt about creating basic document, inserting graphics, constructing tables, various text formatting options, mathematical typesetting, and reference management. To prepare a research manuscript, all these are the prerequisites which are required. So I was setting up your background. So let me move on with today's session. So today the outline of my presentation would be, as according to the title, that is preparing the research manuscript. And in the last section, I will tell you the advantages of using LaTeX. So let me start with the first section, that is preparing the research manuscript. Okay. So let me first show you the research paper that we are going to write in LaTeX. Let me share my screen. Just a minute. So I will show you the research paper first, and then in my slides, we will go topic by topic in it. I have made the screenshots of various portions of the research paper, and then I'll let you know how to focus on each part in LaTeX. Okay, so let me share my screen that of the research paper that I want to write in LaTeX. Okay. So this is a Word document, and I've taken a general paper on development of a paper recycling process, right? So I can think the paper is visible to all. I'll just zoom in more. Okay. So you can see that this is the title of the paper, and we have the authors written here. Then we have their affiliations written over here. Then we have an abstract, then we have some keywords, then the first section is introduction, then we have model and framework, and this is one of the authors who is the corresponding author, so the email address is written at the end of the first page, right? Okay. Then we have, there's a figure there, there's the third section. Okay, so you can see that section 3, so it is 3 point, and then it has certain subsections under it, 3.1, 3.2, and 3.3, 3.4, there is again another figure. Then there is section 4, that is property analysis and test. There is a table inserted here. Then there is a fifth section about conclusion and further study. And finally, we have the references, right? So this paper, we are going to write in LaTeX. So everybody knows that it takes, you know, writing a paper is not a big deal. You can write it, and then formatting is the next challenge. So you can see that within the text, the figures have been cited over here. They have been referred. Then you can also see that this is 5 means the reference number 5 has been cited over here. You can see that this is my fifth reference, and the fifth reference has been cited over here. You can always find it when I move up. You can see that here it is being cited. So these are all the reference numbers, right? So as well as in introduction part also, you can find out the references which have been cited. Then there are certain mathematical terms which have been written within the text. So let's go through all these points. So let me go back to my slides. Let me share my screen. Okay. Okay, so I've shown you the research paper. Let me move on with the next part of the paper. So let's focus on the first section, that is the title, the author's name, and then their affiliation. Now, one of the participants had messaged me that how to write multiple authors and their affiliations in a research paper. So please focus here. Earlier, I just told you to write about one author. So this is how to write about multiple authors. Okay. So I'll show you the screenshot first, and then I will take you to the LaTeX editor page and I'll show you how it is written. So you can see that I have started. Okay, let me go to the LaTeX editor page only. I'll show you directly there. Okay, so this is my LaTeX editor page. Look at the first part. I have started my document since I'm focusing on the research paper. So if you remember, the first part is / document class. Then I have written my class as article, right? And in square brackets, I'm mentioning 12 point. If you remember my first session, the font size 10 point is the default size. So I want my research paper to be written in 12 point size. So I have written in square brackets 12 point, right? Then just skip these things. I'll tell you later on. Then I've written begin document and then I've written end document, right? So I'm just focusing first on the author's name, right? So there were two authors. One was Dibakar Bhattacharjee and the second one was Muhammad Kamrul Islam. Okay, so how to write it? So we will write it as / author. Since this is the first author, so I wanted that it should be written with the number, with the subscript 1. So I'm writing it as 1. I'm writing the name of the author. Then, okay, let me show you the slide once again. And just remember what was it. You can see that the first author is written with a subscript 1A, right? A means A was the corresponding author. So the meaning of A should be written at the bottom of the first page. It should be corresponding author. And the email address will be quoted there. And with the second author, the subscript is 2, right? Superscript is 2, sorry. And then what are these 1 and 2? 1 and 2 are telling me that 1 means the first author's affiliation and 2 means the second author's affiliation, right? Okay, now let me go back to my LaTeX editor page and show you. So you can see that I have given the first author 1 and second author 2. And then Dibakar Bhattacharjee was the corresponding author. So I want a footnote along with it. So I have written / footnote. And what should be the message displayed in the footnote? That he is the corresponding author. And in the next line, I want to display his email address, right? So his email address was dibakar_saxena.m@gmail.com. So if you remember, underscore is a special character, so it will not be displayed. So all these special characters have to be written with a / command. So that is why this underscore is written with the help of a / right? Likewise, I have written the second author, / author, and then I have written in square brackets 2, and I've written the name of the second author. Then I need to write their affiliations. So I have written / FL. FL stands for the command affiliation. So AFFIL, please note it down. Then the first author's affiliation is SRM University, Vellore. And the second author's affiliation is Atish Dipankar University of Science and Technology. Then in a research paper, date is never mentioned. So we write / date and we put the curly braces, but it has to be an empty curly braces, right? Okay. Then what happens is that we will write here. Okay, one of the participants is asking me the question that if both the author's affiliation is same, in that case, you will simply put AFL and you will write their affiliation. You won't write here 1 and 2, right? Similarly, you won't write here 1 and 2, right? You will simply write / author. You will write the name of the author in curly braces. Then you will write / author, you write the name of the second author, and you will simply write FL and you will give the FL. That is fine. Is it clear? Okay. Then, how to display the author and the affiliation in my output. For that, first of all, I have to write after begin document, make title, because only then it will create the title page. And secondly, you can see that I have used a package over here. If there is a single author in your paper, you will only write / author and it will make that title. Due to this affiliation, it will not create the affiliation if you don't give this package. So whenever you have to get the output of the affiliations also, and there are multiple authors present in your paper, then you have to always use a package that is AUTHBLK. So please note it down. So this is the package to be used for creating the authors and the affiliation on the title page, right? Now, one thing to be noted, whenever you use a new package in your LaTeX editor, whenever you will execute this file, it will always prompt a window and it will ask you to install it. So always install, because when you have downloaded your MikTeX file, it is the basic package, right? So whenever new packages you are going to install from the internet, it will again ask you that to install it. So always install them. If you cancel it, then your package will not run, right? So let me execute this. And when I execute, it takes a couple of seconds. And when I execute, you can see that this is my output. So the development of a paper recycling process is the title, the first author, and in the superscript, you can see star and one is written. With the second author, two is written. What is one and two? Their affiliations are written. And then what was the meaning of the star? Star was the name of the footnote. So the footnote has been displayed at the bottom of the page. I have written corresponding author, full stop, next line, email address, right? Now you can see all this star I haven't mentioned. It was marked from LaTeX itself. Now suppose if I want to display the second author's email address also. So what will I do? Let me copy this footnote again. Let me go to the second author's name and let me write the email address. So what happens? It was already not given in the research paper. This is just an additional thing I want to let you know. You can see that the first author, the footnote says star, and for the second author, the footnote symbol has changed. And at the bottom of the page, you can view that both the author's email address have been marked, one with star and the one with a plus sign, right? So all these things are done with LaTeX editor. You don't have to mention the symbols, right? They are done by, right? So let me just remove this. Okay. So I think the title page is clear to everybody. So the title page, I think, is clear. So in the if you want to now these stars and plus sign, they are by default. So nowadays, what happens is that when you submit your research manuscripts to any journal, they always provide you with a template. So whether it is on the discretion of the publishers that whether they want to publish this corresponding author, the asterisk symbol should be asterisk or it should be letters. So it is already the template is given. This is just an example. The template part I will show you at the end of my session. So the star I cannot change. It is by default. So I cannot make it A, right? So one of the participants is asking me that if I want A, then what is to be done? So it is by default in this package. It will be always displayed by star, right? So it is according to the discretion of the publishers what they want. So they will provide the template accordingly, right? So any other doubts so far? Clear. Use package AUTHBLK. This package is used for creating the affiliations and to create multiple authors. This package we didn't use earlier because we just had one author. So if there is only one author written and affiliation was not present there, so just to write the title and to write the author, single author, with the help of make title command, you can do. But if you want multiple authors and affiliations to be written on your title page, you have to use this package AUTHBLK. You don't have to do anything in this package. When you will just, since I have already installed my package in advance, when I will execute this command, before executing, it will display a prompt window here and it will tell you that install that package. So when you click install, laptop will take around 2 to 3 minutes to install that package. And when the installation is done, again execute that command, you will find your display over here, right? So this is about the package. So I hope it is clear. Okay, any more questions in the title page? Fine. So I have divided my manuscript into different sections. So this was the first section, that how to write the title page, right? Now we will focus on the next part, that is how to write the abstract and how to write the keywords, right? So I'm closing this section. Okay, let me go back to my presentation. I have told you to just note down the package and how we are using the footnote option. So the footnote appears on the bottom of the first page only, right? Okay. Now let us focus on the next part of the paper, that is how to write the abstract and how to write the keywords, right? And within the abstract, you can see there is simple text and there are certain mathematical terms like 315.58 gram per meter square. Then you can see that it is written as 2.535 into 10 to the power minus 06 meter cube per gram. Then you can see that it is 16% written here, and again rest are all simple text, right? So text can be written very easily. So I will focus on how to write abstract, how to write keywords, and how to write these technical terms, right? Okay. So let me go. I'll show you the screenshot later on. So let me go to the LaTeX editor page and directly tell you how to write all this. Okay. So now this is my next part. So already I've told you about use package author BLK. Just forget about this line, I'll explain you later on. Title we have done, author one we have done, author two we have done, affiliation one we have done, affiliation two we have done, date we have done. We have already written begin document, meet title, and at the end of the paper we have written end document. Now is the body of your document. So in the body, the first part is the abstract. So whenever we are going to write the abstract, we will enclose it in an environment. And what is that environment? That environment is begin abstract. And when your abstract is all, you will write it as end abstract, right? Now let me tell you about the technical terms that I was focusing in my slide. It was written 315.58 gram per meter square. So meter square, there is a mathematical term used. So in my yesterday session, I told you that whenever you are going to use a mathematical term, you will always enclose that part in dollars. So I have written dollars, and then I'm writing grammar, per means the front slash, and then I'm writing meter to the power, that is the caret symbol, and then I'm writing 2, right? Okay. Then look at the second technical term. The second technical term was 2.535 into 10 to the power minus 06. So how will I write it? 2.535 is written like this. Into. Into means the command used is slash times. Otherwise, if you have kids, you know, in your schooling days, we used to read it like this only. 2.535 times 10 to the power minus 6, right? So the command is also similar. So we write for into, we will write the command as slash times. And then 10 to the power minus 06, there is a group of characters written over here. So I will enclose them in curly braces. And likewise, meter exponent 3 per gram. And I've enclosed this whole thing in dollar signs, right? Then the next technical term was 16%. Percent is a special character. So to print percent, I have to write backslash percentage, right? Because if I don't write backslash percentage, what happens is that otherwise percentage is used to comment your statement. So you can see that the whole thing after your file. So it is mandatory that with special characters, you have to give the simple backslash, right? The rest of the text was simple text, so I've just typed in. Now the next thing is how to write the keywords. So after the environment abstract ends, I have written that backslash keywords. What are my keywords? I had four keywords: paper, tensile strength, recycled paper, and recycling machine. So with the help of commas, I have written all my keywords. Now how to print these keywords? How will I execute these keywords? For that, come to this command. You can see this. So how to get the execution of the keywords? We have to use in the preamble. This is in the preamble part. I have to give the command backslash provide command. Which command? In curly braces, I've written backslash keywords. And then before the keywords are written, I also want it should be written keywords as. If I go back to my slides, you can see that how were the keywords written. The keywords were written as keywords colon, and then the keywords were written there, right? So I want to display that keyword should be written in boldface. So how will I write it in the LaTeX editor? So you can see that I have written in boldface, and I want them in italic also. So I have given in curly braces. First, I have given the command text BF. Text BF means to make it bold-faced. Then I have made the command text IT. Text IT means keyword will be displayed in a italic face, right? And then I have put a colon sign, right? So you have to be very careful about the curly braces, right? The more amount of curly braces are there in your expressions, the more chances of error are there. So whenever you start with a curly brace, always end it before you write the text inside it. So, right? So you can see that if this is my curly brace, it has been ended over here, right? And then there was a curly brace for text IT. You can see this. So this has been ended here. And then there was a curly brace for text BF. So that has been ended at the end, right? So I'll just again focus. For abstract, the environment is begin abstract, end abstract. To display your keywords, you will write backslash keywords, mention all the keywords with a comma sign. And then to display the keywords, you have to give the command in the preamble as provide command keywords. And you also want to print keywords, also should be written over there. So you will write text BF, text IT. This is all optional. You can also, without writing text BF and text IT, you can also display keywords. So keywords will be displayed in the normal font, right? Okay, now let me execute this and show you how it looks like. Okay. So can you see that this is my display? So the title page was already created. So when I give the environment of abstract, you can see that normally abstract is written like this in your text. Abstract is always written at the center, and this is always written at the center of your page, and then the keywords are written like this, right? Okay. Now suppose if you want to write each of the keywords, one of my participants is asking that if I want to write the keywords in italic face, how to write them? You can go to paper and you can write text IT over here. And you can see that the paper has been written in text IT face, right? Likewise, suppose if I want to write recycled paper in italic face. So before that, I will enclose that particular word in curly braces and I will write text IT. And then I can see that particular word has been written in text IT, right? So I think it is clear. Okay. Any questions so far? So we have seen how to write the title page. We have seen how to write the abstract. And we have seen how to write the keywords, right? Okay. So one of the participants is asking me that if the word abstract is to be written along with the text, not at the center, then what to do? Now, again, it is on the discretion of the publisher. So I was just telling you in the beginning also that nowadays templates are available to us. So it is according to the template. Now, in this particular template, abstract will always be written in the center. So if I want a different template for that, the all the journals, they always provide you with a template. So you cannot hamper those templates, howsoever they provide you. You just have to feed in your text there, right? So in this particular section, the abstract will always be written in the center only. You cannot write it along with the text, right? Okay. Okay. So now let me close this section. Okay. Fine. So I'll just close this section and I'll move on with the next section. So let me go to the slides and okay. So when I go to these slides, so we have seen how to write the abstracts. Then, so in this, two things were very, very important. One is how to write the keywords. And then the second thing, how to display the keywords with the help of this command. And then how to write the technical terms within your text, right? Okay. Now we'll focus on the next section, that is introduction, right? In introduction, you can see that this is the first section in my document. It has been numbered as one. And then you can also see that within that introduction, these references have been cited at three places, 1, 2, and 5. So these things I will come at the end of the paper once I have written down the references. So when I complete with my reference section, I will again come back to introduction and let you know how to write these, how to cite them here, right? Now we will just focus on the text part. So let me go to the LaTeX editor screen again. Okay. Now one of the participants is asking me abstract colon. This is what just explained you. This is according to the templates which are available to us. In this particular template, it will be written in abstract in the middle of the page at the center position, and the material of the abstract will start from the next line. You cannot write it as abstract colon, right? So according to the template design, we have to write it. Okay. So let me go to the next part. Okay, let me go to the editor screen. So in the editor screen, you can see that we have done the abstract. Now let us focus on the introduction part. Okay. In the introduction, you can see that I have written it as the section. Since it is a new section, so I'm writing it as / section. The name of the section I've written in capitals. It is according to you. You can write the first letter in capital and the rest in small letters. It is according to you. And then there were two paragraphs in that section. So I've written the first paragraph till here. Then I've written double / and I'm writing the second paragraph, right? So this is my first section. I will come to the technicalities, the citation process later on after I complete with my references. So this is the introduction part. And when I execute it, what do I see in my output? You can check. This is how my output looks. You can see that the title page was written over here. Then we had the abstract. And then the first section appears as one as introduction, right? Again, one dot is not appearing because in this template, it is being mentioned as one. So in different templates, these designs would be different, right? Okay. So we will come to the citation process at the end. So this is my first section. So let me focus on to the next section. Okay, let me go back to the slides again and show you the next section first. So we are done with the introduction part. This is what the screenshot shows you. Then is the next section. This is written over here, and there is a citation over here. This is the third reference of your manuscript. So again, the citation process, I will come to the later part, right? Okay. So how to write it? I think now you can do it. You will again mention it as a section and you will write that section in simple text. So let me show you. So you can see that abstract, we are done. We are done with the introduction also. And this is my third section. So you can see I've given it the name section, model and framework. There were again two paragraphs. So after the first paragraph, I've written double backslash and then the second paragraph. Okay. If you want it in IEEE format, sir, then you have to download the template from IEEE. This is what I'm saying repeatedly, that it is according to the format that is available as a template. So if you are writing, suppose you want to send your research manuscript to a IEEE conference or a IEEE journal, the template is always provided there. Suppose if I want to send a journal, my research paper to a elsewhere journal, so whenever you are going to read for the author guidelines, they always provide you with a template, right? So then in that template, you need to download that template and the design is already available to you. You don't make any changes in the design part. You just have to feed in your text, right? So all these changes I'll tell you in the last section of my today's talk. So just wait for a couple of minutes. So this is just a basic structure of how to write a research paper, right? Whatever we have done so far, I'm just compiling them together. So this is my second section. So the name of the section is model and framework, right? And so I've told you how to write the second one, that is model and framework. So you can see that the second section appears like this. And then after the second section, there was a figure which had a caption and it was figure one. The caption was design of hand operated pulper, right? Now how to insert this? Figures, I told you that it is done with the help of a environment, begin figure and end figure. So let me go to that section. So you can see that we are done with all these things. Now after model and framework, I have written begin figure, end figure. I have saved the figure in the same folder in which I'm working. I have given that figure name as one. And then I want that the scale of the figure should be one. So the scale is according to you, how you want your figure to appear in your text. And then the caption is written as design of hand operated pulper, right? And then I'm labeling it as figure one. I'm giving it the name figure one. So whenever I will call it in my text, I will call it by the name figure one, right? So begin figure, end figure, caption is written and I've labeled it as figure one. Let me execute it and show you. So you can see that the figure appears. The introduction is done. We have the model and framework section and then comes the figure. Now, one of the participants had asked me that if I want to paste my figure in one, but in just, suppose I want to paste my figure just below the introduction, how to do it? What will I do then? Suppose I want to paste my figure after the introduction, I will copy this command. I've just cut from there. And after my introduction, with the figure environment, I have to write in square brackets HT. HT means to paste the figure right after here, when I want. Otherwise, what LaTeX do? LaTeX adjusts the figure according to the page size. Wherever it finds that the text is little over here, it will paste your figure accordingly, right? Otherwise, but if you want the figure to be pasted at one particular section, so you have to give the command HT along with it. Now, let me execute and show you how it is done. So can you see that the figure is pasted after the introduction, right? Likewise, if you want your figure to be pasted after section two, that is model and framework, what will I do? I will just cut the figure from here and I'll just paste it after my model and framework section finishes. And when I paste over here and when I execute my command, I will see that after the section 2 finishes off, my figure is pasted over there. So this was my section 2. So after the section 2, my figure appears over here, right? Okay. The purpose of HT means to paste the figure here at this position. Otherwise, if you don't give this command, it will be pasted according to the size of the paper. Wherever it will find space in your, because it is doing it on its own. So wherever it will find space in your document, it will paste it accordingly. But if I give this command HT, it will place it after this command roller, right? Wherever you have finished your text, it will paste it there. This is the role of HT command, right? Okay. So after the figure command, let's move on to the next section. I'll go back to my slides again. So you can see that below the figure, the caption is pasted over here, right? Okay. So we move with the next section, that is the third section, setup and procedure. In setup and procedure, you can see that there is some text, then there are some bullets over here, then there are four subsections written over here, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, and 3.4. So how to focus on the third section? So let me go back to the LaTeX editor screen. And you can also see that after the third section, there is figure 2 and it has a caption, pulp making and screening. So let me see how to write all these things in the LaTeX editor screen. Let me share the screen with you. Okay, so let's come over here. Let's go to the third section, that is setup and procedure. So I have given it the name section, setup and procedure. The first paragraph was as such written over here. Then we had in the recycling of waste paper, mainly the following processes were followed, double backslash to make it enter the next line. Then this part of the text was written in bullets. So I'm using the environment, begin itemize, end itemize. And then with every item, I have to give the command backslash item. So before pulping, I've written backslash item. Before screening, I've written backslash item. Likewise for rolling and drying. Then all these four, they were categorized as four different subsections. So you can see that I've written subsection pulping, subsection screening, subsection rolling, and subsection drying and paper making. And then you can see that I have written the second figure, that is begin figure, end figure. I want my figure to be pasted at the center of my page. Then I've written include graphics. I've given it scale 1. The name of the second figure is 2. So you can see that it is showing me second figure. And then the caption that I want is pulp making and screening. And then I have labeled it as figure 2. So wherever I will call it in my text, I will call it as figure 2. So you can see that in this part, I am referring also that this part is referring to figure number 2. So how have I written it? I'm writing figure dot and then I'm using the command refer, R-E-F. And then I'm calling it with the same name with what I have labeled it. So this figure was labeled as figure 2. So I'm calling it with the same name. So I'm giving it figure 2, right? Now when I execute this, so you can see that your output is like this. And you can see that how your third section looks like. Then we have the bullets written like this. The subsections have been numbered on their own, 3.1, then 3.2. Then, okay. Now, can you see the difference? Look at the figure where it is appearing. It is appearing after 3.1, but where have I given the command? This is what I wanted to show you. So it is appearing after pulping section, right? But I have given my command over here. That means I haven't written HT over here. So the figure is pasted according to the size, right? Now suppose if I give HT command over here, it will be right pasted after drawing and paper making section, right? So you can see the difference. So you can see that after drawing and paper making only the figure appears, right? And then the next thing that I want to make you clear is, after the figure, I have written, the caption is written over here, and this figure 2 is written by LaTeX itself. And in this part, look at this, I was referring over here. So figure 2, since this is the second figure in my document, it is automatically numbered as 2. I am not writing 1 or 2 here. Suppose if I write ABC over here, if I give the name ABC and if I give the name ABC over here, still it will be called as 2 only. You can see the output. See. So you can call by any name. So whatever is the order of the figure in your document, it will be ordered by that number, right? So this is what I wanted to make you clear. Okay. So this was the section 3rd, right? So I hope there is no doubt still here. Okay. So now we move on with the next section. Let me go to the editor presentation. So this is how we did the third section. And then is the fourth section, that is property analysis and tests. And then we have a table also there, right? So it's a simple table. There are two columns and there are few rows. Okay. So let me explain this in the LaTeX editor. Okay. So let's move on to the fourth section now. Here it comes. So you can see backslash section, then I've written property analysis and tests. And then the table, as I explained to you earlier, it has been enclosed with the environment begin tabular. Then the justification is that I want my text to be written as left justified. And I want vertical lines in between the columns. So I've written vertical line L, vertical line L, and vertical line. Then the table was starting with a horizontal line. So I've written H line for it. Then there were two columns. So I've written property and dimensions. It will move to the next row with the help of the backslash command. Then again, a horizontal line, H line, length of paper board and 26 centimeter double backslash. Then there is H line again. Then we have width of paper board and 19.5 centimeter. Then we have written H line, area of paper board, and you can see that M to the power 2 is written within dollars. Then we have weight of paper board. Then we have grammage. Again, grammage, the units are gram per meter squared. So you can see how it is written. And then we have thickness of paper board. And then the final part was bulk. And this term was 2.535, like it was written in the beginning in the introduction part. Multiply, so multiply is written with the help of times, right? 10 to the power minus 0.6. Then I've ended my table with the environment end tabular. And when we execute it, the execution shows. So you can see that this is the fourth section, property analysis and tests, and this is the table, right? Okay. Now, the next section of the presentation, that is, so we have seen how the table is created. Then we have conclusions and further study. So this is again simple enough. So we have a section. And we will write the simple text written here, right? So just let me quickly. Okay. So you can see that I've written my section conclusions and further study over here. There were two sections, two paragraphs. So after the first paragraph ends, I've put a double backslash. Then the second paragraph ends over here, double backslash, and then the last line, right? And when I execute, I get my last section, right? Okay, so one of the participants is asking me that if you don't want a number for conclusion like 5, so if you want don't want to number your conclusion, you will simply use the environment section star. I told you yesterday also that if you don't want to give a number, you can execute and see that I didn't want a number to this section, so I've just written section star, right? So if you want a number, you will simply write section. If you don't want a number, you will write section star, right? Okay. And then we come to the last part, that is how to write the references. So let's go to the last part. Let me just go back to the slides again. Okay. So these are my references. So there are 5 references. So this is how it is written over here. And now let me go to the again editor part and show you how these references are written. Okay. So you can see this is how the references are written. I have written bib item 1. So I'm giving it the name that the first reference is named as 1. Bib item 2, this is the second reference. You can write it in any way, it is according to you. Then I'm writing bib item 3, then bib item 4 and bib item 5. And they have been enclosed in the environment begin the bibliography, and we want to write it as end the bibliography, right? Okay. Then, and I also told you that whenever you write bibliography, it is always, there is a random number written over here. It can be any random number, right? And when I execute it, I can see that at the end, this is how my references look like, right? So this is how the references will appear. Now is that I wanted to cite my references in between the text. Okay. So how to cite the references within the text? So you can see in the introduction part, right over here, you can see this, it is written as 1, how to cite it over here. So the first references, what name did I give it? I gave it the name 1. You can give any number. You can give C, A, like you can give anything. So I've given it the number 1. So I will go to this part, introduction, downstream. So after downstream, you can see what have I written? I've written cite 1. So when I cite 1, it will go to the bib item 1 and it will call that number here. And when I execute it, it will give you the number 1 displayed over here, right? Again, 1, 2, 3 doesn't matter. You can give any name. Suppose if I take the first letters of the authors. So if I give this the name CA. So if I go back to my text in the introduction part, if I cite this as CA, automatically, after downstream, 1 is only displayed over here, right? Likewise, you can check out the second one. After Philadelphia, citation 2 has been written. So you can see that I have given the second reference with the name 2. So after Philadelphia, I'm writing cite 2, right? Okay. Then you can see that pulp, after pulp, citation 5 is written over here. So after pulp, I've written cite 5, right? Likewise, within your text anywhere, suppose in the model and framework section here, I have cited 3. So you can see that in the model and framework section, you will find the citation 3 over here. So you can cite anywhere within the text. Now, suppose I change my order in the bibliography. Suppose I make this, let me take this bibliography and put it at the end, right? And let me just alter all these things. Let me again change this position and let me put it somewhere over here. Right. So what it will do, I have only changed the bibliography part, right? I have changed the order. But the numbering that is given earlier in the text, I haven't changed anything there. So when I execute this, automatically all those numbers will be changed, right? Let's see, are they changed or not? So now if you check the references, the first citation, that is counseling council, this one was earlier given the number 1. Now it is being given the number 5. Let me see what happens in the text. This was in the introduction part. The first, you can see here, this was earlier number 1. Now it is number 5. So this is the advantage. So in of using LaTeX, right? Okay. Again, so one of the participants is asking me that if you want to cite right, so just after this I'll show you the template also for an elsewhere journal. So that is again according to the discretion of the publishers how they want to design your text. So how to use it, I'll just let you know. Okay, so I guess that the basic how to write a paper, it is now clear to you that how we use LaTeX to write a paper. And I guess that it becomes a bit easier. Yes, one of the participants is asking me that the draft of my research paper is already written in Word document. Can I import this document in LaTeX and then make the changes? Yes, sir. You can always copy your text portion from Word and you can paste it over here. This is what I have also done. I showed you in the beginning a Word document only. So all the sections were being copied from there. You cannot import the whole document as such from Word and put it in LaTeX. You have to do it part wise. So you can copy the sections, each sections from your document, and you can paste it over LaTeX, right? Okay. So this was the basic document, right? Now, let me talk about the template that I was telling you till now. Okay. So before we go to the questions, I'll just tell you about the template. Let me show you the design for that. Nowadays, our job is done very easy now. Now, wherever we have to send our paper for publication, in your author guidelines, if you open that, you will always find that they want certain font size. They want they give you the guidelines how you want the paper to design, right? So in Word, they provide you with a template in Word also, and they provide you with a template in LaTeX also, right? So what you have to do is that you just have to download that template, that file from that journal site. It will be always downloaded in a zip folder. You need to unzip that folder, and then within that folder, you can see that the LaTeX document is present there. So a LaTeX document will always have an extension .tech. So you need to open that file. So this is a journal from the Elsevier journal. I have just downloaded an Else article template. So this is my .tech file. So when I execute this file, I'll just show you how it is executed. So this is how the template is given to you from the publisher end, right? Now what you want to do is that you want to insert your document, your data inside this template. So what will you do? For that, you need a little basic knowledge of LaTeX, right? If you have that basic knowledge, you will be easily able to edit this. So now see, this is the title of the template. So you will go to the source editor and you will see that this is where the title is written, right? So they are writing Elsevier template and they are writing many things. So what I will do, I will simply select this part and I will delete it, right? And I will insert my own title. Let me insert webinar on LaTeX, right? Title changes. Likewise, everywhere you can see that author is written here. So I will go to the author. whatever is written over here, I will delete that. I'll write the author name over here, right? When I again execute it, I can see that the author has been changed, right? Same way, address, I can just delete this. I will write my address affiliation and I will execute it, right? So you can see it's very easy. So you don't have to do anything. You just have to delete the text written over here and you need to insert your own text. So everything is provided over here, everything. How to write begin abstract. See, this template is telling you they want their abstract to be written with these horizontal lines also. So you don't have to do anything. You will just go to this portion, go to this text and delete this text, insert your own text over here, right? Insert your own text. So this is how your text appears. Then they're giving the keywords. The template here shows the keywords are being written in. Keywords over here and they will appear as such, right? So this is the first keyword. So I can write here art one. This is the second keyword. So I will write art two. Let me third keyword, art three and art four. Now when I execute it, you can see that all the keywords are changed, right? And this is the classification number. You need to search it from the internet first and then you need to feed on. Then this is the first section, how they are writing it. And likewise, you can change, make the changes over here and you will get your own research paper written in this format, right? So in any journal, wherever you want to communicate your paper, they always provide you with a template, right? So with your basic knowledge of LaTeX, you can always be able to write your document in LaTeX and you can share your PDF file with them. So whenever you execute this command in your folder, the PDF will be generated along with it and you can communicate to the publishers the PDF. And once your paper is accepted, then they ask for the source file. So then you need to provide them with the source files, right? So I hope I'm able to justify the title of the topic. I could explain that how you can write research papers in LaTeX. Okay. Let me go back to these slides. Okay, so there is a quick question before we move on to the last section of the talk today. And the question is, quickly mark your answers. Yes, so I close the question. So 72% are marking it as / refer. Yes, it is the correct one. Figures can be referred in the manuscript with the help of / refer, and references can be referred in the manuscript with the command / cite, right? And here goes the second question. Okay, so let me close the question. Yes, many of you are correct. So it is author BLK, AUTHBLK, right? Okay. So we move on to the last section of my talk today. That is, what are the advantages of using LaTeX? Okay, there is a question. Okay, no. The typesetting of mathematical formula is supported in a very convenient way. Even complex structures such as footnotes, references, tables of contents, and bibliographies can be generated easily. It encourages the authors to write well-structured texts. It is highly portable and free. It is user friendly. Then LaTeX files, they contain the markup language that enables them to be readily converted to other outputs like PDF, allowing you to share your document more easily than it was in another format. Now, usually what happens is that when we write a lot of equations in Word, and when you send that document to somebody else, the settings, they change, right? So, but if you share your PDF document with anybody, the settings are never changed. So this is one more advantage of using LaTeX. LaTeX is designed for producing beautifully typeset mathematics easier than any other equation editor, right? So with this, we come to the end of this session and to this FDP also. Still, if you have any doubts, you can always reach out to me at tanya.bose@chitkara.edu.in. And before I end, there are a few important notes for the participants. Already I mailed you yesterday, but still I just want to make an announcement. Firstly, all the participants are requested to send their photographs, preferably in formals, while watching the webinar in front of their laptops to my mail address by 1:30 p.m. We will be preparing a collage and sharing with you. Secondly, you are all requested to fill the feedback forms that have been communicated to you yesterday. Thirdly, certificates will be provided to all those participants who have more than 50% attendance. So for Chitkara faculty and students, hard copy of the certificates will be provided. And for outstation participants who are outside Chitkara University, we will mail you the e-certificates as soon as possible, right? And in this FDP, we had participants from diversified fields, like from Chitkara, we had from CSE department, applied science, applied engineering, architecture and design, nursing, curing, School of Art and Design, School of Planning and Architecture, and Education. While there were outstation participants also from Panipat University, Panipat Institute of Engineering and Technology, and Amity University, Haryana. So, on behalf of Dr. Mohit Kumar Kakkar, Assistant Dean, Department of Applied Sciences, I want to convey thanks to all the participants for completing this FDP in this crucial time. And I want to thank the outstation participants for showing their interest. Special thanks to IT department for their valuable support. Take care, stay home, and stay safe. Okay, I end the session here. Bye. Okay.